It depends on the day. I really like salads. I eat lots of salad. But I don't really, a lot of people are like, do you like to do diets and stuff? I'm like, no, we honestly have, we can eat whatever we want because we don't like traveling and stuff. It's really hard to like eat like a certain way and eat like at like a certain time and like be on like a diet because you can't really do that when you're traveling. It's so difficult, trust me, we've all tried. But we can't like eat, it's really hard to eat super good on the road. But when I'm home, I try to eat like really good. And in the morning, I have like eggs or something, and then I have like a turkey burger before I go to dance. And then I go to dance, and I try to have like a snack in between dance, like a protein bar. And then when I get home, I eat like chicken, and then I go to bed. But sometimes ice cream before dance, that's always good. It just depends. I mean, LA is always the best. I love California so much. I just love California, so we have lots of, whenever we're in California, we have lots of competitions there because, I mean, that's where we are. So that was really nice. I really like New York, too. How I got into Active Ultimate was they literally called me and my mom, they called us the first season to be on the show, but it was supposed to be called, like, Ultimate Dance Mom or something, and we were like, we're not doing that. So then we didn't do the first season. And then they called us like every day. Can you please audition for season two? Can you please audition for season two? Like literally every time I was in front of my mom, she was on the phone with them. So then finally we're like, yeah, sure, I don't care. We'll do it. So then we did it. And then oh my God, we didn't think we were gonna get on the show because they sent you to New York for like 2 days to do like the, it's like the last round to pick who's gonna be on like the show. So anyways, I was horrible in the interview. I literally was like, Mom, when can we go? Like my stomach hurt so bad, like I was like sick and I was not feeling that interview. And I forgot my solo when I was doing it in front of hundreds of people. I mean, I don't really get nervous when I do that, so I was just kind of like, oh, it looks like I got improv, but like I forgot it. My mom was literally like, you're still bad and you're not gonna get, like my mom doesn't want to be on the show, so she was like, you're not gonna get on the show. So I was like, all right, and I was kind of sad. I was like, oh dang it, I messed that up for myself. And then they called us and like, my mom gave me a little cookie and was like, AUDC. And I was like, Mom, what does that stand for? And then I was like, oh wait, that's Axe Ultimate. So then we were on the show and I had to leave home for a very, 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 very long time. And I was really upset. Like me and all my friends cried for like hours. So yeah, that's how I got on the Axe Ultimate and that's how I got on the Dance Moms. Everything seems super dramatic on the show. Literally everything. Like, and they sometimes like twist your words and stuff, so it's like really annoying. I don't watch the show, so I honestly have no idea whatever happens. I live it, so I'm like, I live it, so why do I want to watch it on TV again? So none of us really watch the show, so I really don't know how to answer that question because I don't know. I feel like everything's dramatic. Even if it's like, no, one time like my toenail fell off and I was like, hey Abby, can I go get like an ice pack and just sit out for a second because I have my toenail. And they literally came up to me and they were like, okay, your mom's coming in right now, are you okay? Do you need to go to urgent care? And I was like, I'm literally just fine. And then like my mom walks in and is like, are you okay? And I'm like, yeah. She's like, well, they told me you were like about to die. Like the producers were literally like, your daughter's about to die. Like her toenail's off, like her nail, like her whole toe's gonna fall off. And like my mom walks in and is like, are you okay? And I'm like, yeah, I'm just sitting here. And I'm like, nothing's wrong. And then the doctor's like, why are you in here? And they were like, well, they told me my daughter's toe was gonna fall off, so I thought I'd come. And then nothing really happened. And the producer's like, why did you make that a big deal? I'm like, because it wasn't. Like, nothing happened. And like, I'm a trooper. Like, if I get hurt, I'm like, whatever. Like, I'm the one that like usually never cries. Except for these last few episodes, I cried. That was the first time I've ever been dramatic in my life. I'm never dramatic. I mean, I get answered for the show, but ever since 2 years, maybe? That's how long it's been. 2 years goes by too fast. No, our show is not scripted. It's reality TV. So everything that happens, happens. So like what you see on TV, it really happened. Like that fight really happened. Like it's not, I mean, it's like really produced. It's happening, but everything that happens, it that's what happens. So nothing's scripted. The show's not scripted. There's like, they really produce it. So they're like, so-and-so said this about you. So then they go and get mad because that's what they heard they said about them, you know? So. It's just a really pretty show, but that doesn't mean that we have a script that we read off of, because it is supposed to be reality. kinda. I watched it whenever like it first came out, so I was like, oh cool, a dance show, you know? Like I feel like I was younger and I was like, wow, a dance show, that seems really cool to watch. And then I kinda stopped watching it because I watched like the first like season-ish, but I didn't really watch it. Like I had it recorded, but I didn't watch it all the time. But I'm really busy, so it's like hard to, it's on like a Tuesday night and it's like, well, I have dance, so there's like no possible way of me getting home in time to go watch it. And I don't know, like TV isn't like my main priority, so I would always like, I would like watch it sometimes. I mean, I heard about it and I would always like see it and know about it. And like I had a few friends that were on Abby's Ultimate season 1 that I know, so I was like, oh, I'll watch that because I have some friends on it. So, yes and no. They're all so hard. There's so many tricks in it. hard one. That one, war one, was a war torn. That one's pretty hard. I'm trying to think of like a really hard, stressful one. There's this one, our national one, is pretty stressful. Stressful dance, I don't think it is. It's pretty stressful. So they're all pretty stressful because we learn them so fast. That like you feel like you're gonna forget it because you forgot it backstage because you learned it 2 minutes ago, you know? Like sometimes we learn it in the car on the way to competition. You know, so it's like really nerve-wracking. All times. Well, a few years ago I won the dance awards. So like I won junior, so I was so excited because also we've been gone so much and it's really hard to like train while filming the show, and I was just like, I was so happy. It's like the dance one is kind of like, I feel like that's kind of like home to me. Like I love going to like those conventions. I get so much fun, and I feel like I was one of you guys because of the people that like go on impress. So I love the dance awards, and I was very like the top 10, like the improv. I don't know if some of you don't know. I'm assuming you know what I'm talking about. Like the top 10 improv, I feel like that's the most stressful part of the entire competition. Like that's probably the most stressful. And then after that, it's like your top 3, it's like the solo, and you're like, okay, just do your solo, good, no, it's okay. And then I also really love the plaques. The plaques are probably the best part, because I got third whenever I was a mini, and then I won when I was a junior, and then I got third this year. So like I have these plaques, and I have the perfect place for my room. So I really love the plaques, but very scary. It's all scary. That competition. No, we're all actually homeschooled because it's literally impossible to actually go to real school. Because first of all, whenever we were filming in Pittsburgh, I don't live in Pittsburgh, so it's like I had to be homeschooled. There was no possible way. I actually started being homeschooled like middle of sixth grade because in sixth grade I was going back and forth and I started dance at 1 o'clock. So my school was very lucky to have them do like a half day program for me. something like that, but now we all have to be homeschooled because there's no possible way of us leaving. So say we went to school, so we went to school for like the first 2 months, and then we would have to leave for 16 weeks. So then you'd have to be homeschooled for 16 weeks, and like you couldn't be there, like the teacher couldn't be there to take the test with you and like stuff like that, because we have a tutor. So we're all pretty much like cyber-schooled, or we all have tutors back home. So like we all have our own tutors that teach us whenever we're at home. So like whenever I'm in Arizona, I have a tutor that comes to my house and teaches me for like 3 hours.